This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to use Infinix Flash Tool. Now it's pretty much the same thing as, it pretty much works the same way SP Flash Tool does, only that it's a lot simpler, you know, fewer configuration options, just load your file and flash. That's basically how this one works. Now before you use your Infinix Flash Tool, first you need your ROM. Okay, this is my Infinix Flash Tool here. You need the ROM you wish to flash, which I've extracted here. And then you need to install your Mediatek VCOM driver. So the first thing you would do would be to install your VCOM drivers. Without your VCOM drivers, the tool will not be able to detect your phone. So once you connect your phone for flashing, the best you could see is just a charging sign on the screen. No flashing will start. So you want to go to your device manager. Just click on any item on the list, then you click on action, add legacy hardware, next, install the hardware that I manually select from a list, next, you click on hard disk. Now you click on browse. Now you navigate to the location of your Mediatek VCOM driver. This is mine here, Mediatek. Let me take you back. Mediatek VCOM drivers, USB VCOM driver. Now you select the folder according to your PC spec. I'm using a Windows 8, so I'm going to select the Windows 7 driver. Now mine is a 64-bit PC, so I will select 64. If yours is a 32-bit PC, you would want to select this, but mine is a 64, so I select this, open. Okay, next. If you get a prompt telling you that this driver is not signed and did you want to proceed, you'd want to click a yes for that. So the reason why you are getting this code 10 error is because the driver you just installed is not digitally signed. So Windows believes it might not exactly work, but that really doesn't matter. What you are after is this: the following hardware was installed, Mediatek, that USB VCOM port. So VCOM drivers have been installed. So you click on finish. Now back to flashing. Now we have our drivers installed. So the first thing you want to do is to launch your Infinix Flash Tool. So you right click Flash Tool, run as administrator. Click on yes and just wait for the tool to pop up. So it's pretty much the same as SP Flash Tool. You'll see that the settings are a lot simpler. Yes. Now for SP Flash Tool, you have a lot of options at the top which allows you to select which files you wish to flash. But with this, it doesn't exactly work that way, but that doesn't matter. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is to, at this point, switch off your phone, and then don't yet connect the phone to the PC via USB cord. You just switch off the phone and leave the phone the way it is. Now you want to click this browser. This is supposed to be browser anyway. So you click this button, then you navigate the location of the backup you wish to flash. Let me take you back. So you see, this is the stock backup I wish to flash, or the stock ROM. So you open, you select the scatter file and click open. So now we have the file loaded here. So the next thing you want to do is to click start. Now you see that start is grayed and stop is green in color. So that means we are good to go. So what I'd want to do next is to connect the switched off phone to the PC via the USB cord, and then flashing should begin. So I'll do that just now. Okay, so my flashing has begun. It's very important you do not interrupt this process. You just leave it to complete before you disconnect the phone and then boot it up. Do not interrupt this process. Alright, flashing has begun. So I just waited 100% before I disconnect. Alright, so flashing was successful and I have this green OK prompt. Now, if the phone is stuck at boot logo after flashing, just take out the battery if the battery is removable. But if your battery is inbuilt, just boot into recovery mode and do a factory reset, and you should be taken to the setup wizard.